And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Drinking my Monster Energy drink, slamming into walls, bro. I'm eating some fucking beef jerky. Ray kicking.
Drinking some Code Red.
It's the Bonfire Comedy Central Radio Series XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Oakerson. Of course, everyone here is with us. The Lou's, black and white Lou, Christine and Jacob.
The Lou's.
The Lou's.
And the Lou's.
At the Bonfire SXM on Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, all the social media. Social media.
I'm so much enjoying this still.
This article, yeah, because we do the lost tapes before this, so we were running hot on the lost tapes, but I had to stop
be fun
at
times.
That. Yeah, those of course air Thursdays, 6 to 8 p.m. on Comedy Central Radio. But Lou 2 gave us an article that I wanted to do on the pre-record, but you were like, let's wait for listeners who might be able to call in at 844-266-3399. Airdropping, which I found out, no shit, I found it about on Saturday.
Me too.
Really? Just completely on, how did you learn about airdropping photos?
Isabella.
Your daughter.
My daughter. I was supposed to send some pictures to Christine, and she goes, let me just airdrop them to you. And I was kind of curious on what that was, and she said, yeah, if someone's right there,
no.
I guess, and they have their Bluetooth on.
Yeah.
You can just send.
My girlfriend airdropped photos to Mike Vecchione, my roommate.
Yeah.
Pure puss pics. Actually, it was photos from the day we hung out.
She wrote box knowledge above them.
But it was also like showing a torch to Frankenstein. He was like, she's like, give me your phone. He's like, But now a big thing in New York City is women are discovering that creepy men are using the iPhone AirDrop app to send them photos of their dicks while they're on the train.
Now wait, how does it appear? AirDrop.
I'm reading right now. Our girl's riding the Uptown 6 train.
Now, was anybody aware, like Christine, you got
a message popped up on her smartphone. iPhone 1 would like to share a note with you, read the note sent at 6:51 p.m. She hit accept and was horrified by what she saw. It was just a huge close-up picture of a disgusting penis.
Well,
the guy that sent it was probably like, actually, it wasn't. It took him like 17 shots to get there. So
also, at first, he's kind of like a huge, and he's like, hey!
Just
gross.
Oh. said Carlson of Bushwick, Brooklyn. By the way, she's from I wonder if she's from like actual Bushwick or if she's like a hipster or she's like, it was the close-up. The message was titled Straw and was sent by an anonymous stranger.
Straw.
It really That's felt great. Like someone had actually just flashed me. Well, I mean, I think seeing a dick live on the subway, it's like hockey. You see it live and you're like, whoa, that's way different than, I remember the first time I saw a homeless guy jerk off.
I heard I would only enjoy hockey if I watched it live.
That's maybe about watching homeless dudes jerk off.
Is it homeless? No,
it's homeless. Not homeless. This is clearly, you have to have an iPhone to do this.
That doesn't mean shit anymore.
No, yeah, you're right. I saw a homeless guy texting.
I saw six homeless heroin kids sleeping on the street in my neighborhood the other day.
On their iPhones?
All of them holding iPhones, yeah.
That's crazy.
They were all huddled around the things they could charge their iPhones.
I'm looking for a bus ticket to Buffalo. I need $2 more, some heroin, and also, you guys, like, got a charge?
The girl's picture in the article here is fantastic. She goes, oh, God, every subway ride, that's another dick pic.
Bloop, bloop. That's probably a dick.
Straw. I heard this one before.
This is the face of every bartender when I've gotten too drunk and tried to be charming.
Yeah. So, why are we not fingering in the bathroom?
Yeah.
Dude, just pay your bill and go.
Do you want another Bud Light? Because we're about to close.
Hey, do you have your Bluetooth on?
Yeah.
All right, wait here.
Do you like straws? Do you like swirly straws? Do you like straws that bend?
It's a fun. You have a fun sipper.
Yeah, you have a fun sipper dick pic.
It just goes all over like a fucking water spot.
I had some fun in Photoshop. I made it do a couple things it doesn't actually do.
First of all, if you're horrified. Wait, how old is she now?
So.
She's 28 years old. If you see a huge close-up dick pic from a messaging on your phone, and you're horrified, move the fuck out of New York, man.
Yeah.
Move out of New York. I mean, that's a bit much.
Like, here's the thing about...
The fact, I was horrified. I mean, why, you'd sort of like, why don't you just laugh at that and...
Well, let me tell you why she probably feels horrified is the...
If she was next to her nana.
Yeah. The call was coming from inside the house.
Because the call was coming from inside...
The dick was inside the phone! Because there's something weird about a message popping up on your phone, and it's like, I hate when I get a text from a number I don't know, it's like, hey, and you're like, who is this? And they're like, why? Like, they play that game, you're like, no, I'll block you. I have no problem blocking numbers. But to get a dick pic like that, you're like, ah, shit. Like, is it someone I knew? I would immediately think it's a friend. If I got a dick pic, I'd be like, what dick is that? Is that Lewis's dick? Is that Joe List's dick?
And now let's go ahead and say that I tell you, the reveal is I go, that dick belongs to somebody on this train. You can now spend your rest of your train ride guessing who's dick.
Oh, I mean, that's like I'm sorry you don't like the live-action role-playing of Dick Detective?
Yeah. Private dicks?
Oh, dude, I would ride the 6 train. If someone told me that between the hours of 6:30 and 7, you get to do a fucking detective dick mission.
Unprivate dicks.
Unprivate dicks.
That's the name of the show.
Well, they say that people often forget to switch the setting off from everyone or don't realize they have it turned on. And it never crossed my mind that someone may use it to send stuff like that. All right, that quote's dumb.
I won't. So wait, can I do this?
Yeah, so you slide up.
Will I get in trouble? Will come back to my number?
Dude, that's so great.
Huh?
Frankie Nasevich, 35, had just gotten off a train at Penn Station when an invitation to open Eduardo's picture with a preview photo of a man's junk popped up on his screen. I wanted to punch him in the mouth for carelessly buckshotting genitalia to phones that could potentially be owned by children.
Oh. I'm not going to send a dick pic. I want to do it, but I just want to do like racist memes or something.
Or just fun photos of yourself.
No, I don't want it to ever be me. I want it to be more like just like outlandish things. I do want to freak people out, but dick pic, that's passe. Unless I would just send like the best, awesomest pictures of like dick pics, like black dicks.
Dude, maybe. That's so funny.
Just big meaty ones. The ones that make everyone, like I'll make you, but when you're like, oh my God, I was horrified by what I saw, I'll be like, oh, I bet. That was a big, big, meaty dick.
Well, Serial, this is such a great quote. In the past, flashers would have to go out in public in a trench coat and risk getting arrested, said Brad Salzman, a sex addiction therapist. Now, their minds can run wild. Don't you understand? They're evolving.
Just when I bought stock in trench coats.
Yeah. This has done wonders for the trench coat business is in the gutter.
We've got to get sales are down.
Yeah. It's just fucking old reporters and fucking perverts.
And all the reporters are online now.
Yeah, everything's moved online. Even the dick, even the flashing.
The real person who suffered from the technology era is the trench coat.
But
turns out
to say that to have a
picture. All it is now is the trench coats are used for is for putting over 3-stack midgets trying to get into a movies for one price.
True, that's it. That's literally it.
Outside of that,
good luck.
Trench coat business. Does anybody here own a trench coat?
I'm Evan Trenchcoat. My family lost all of its money.
I've been talked into buying a trench coat several times. Never going to have them.
Is a trench coat the same as a duster? Because I really want a duster.
No, you don't.
Yeah, I do.
Come on, Dan.
I mean, I couldn't wear it. Seriously.
You want to just own it?
I would, dude, if it was in the Wild
you
West.
You want to get like a real like crow one, too, that has like the half cape on the back?
Yeah, they did it on Always Sunny, and I totally got why they were saying it, because it's awesome.
Lorenzo Lamas.
Yeah, dusters are awesome. Look at that.
No, there's the one with the cape. Get that Van Helsing one straight there. Yeah.
No, I don't like that one.
I'll get you that one.
That's dumb. That
if looks... you'll wear that one,
no,
I'll get it for you.
I want to wear a cowboy one, not a Van Helsing.
They are.
No, that's Van Helsing. I want the cowboy one.
Burberry.
It's just like the most classic trench coat, so it's good to bring it up.
We don't want a trench coat. We want dusters.
Yeah.
Yeah. But, no, wait. Go up.
Oh, so, look at this one.
Yeah.
Oh, badass.
Dan, it looks like that might just be you with a mustache, quite honestly. I think that's you with a mustache. Tell me that's not you with a mustache. I mean, I would say somebody photoshopped that, but there's no reason to.
At the Bonfire,
that's you with a mustache.
At the Bonfire SXM on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat to see the picture. That seriously does look like my face.
That could just be you with a mustache drawn on.
That's Montana Dan.
Mondana.
Mondana. How you doing?
I'm actually, Dana Mondana.
In this world, I grew up with Gary. We went to Montana. Seeking fortune. Trish died, and Gary took me north to Montana.
Go back to the other one, Christine.
Missouri.
Go back to the main page.
Ooh, sexy dusters.
Wait, go up.
Yeah, so this is different than a trench coat.
Go up, up, up. No, hang on.
Hi.
This is what you got when you did dusters?
Yeah.
Go down. Oh, no, there. That with the back. The guy's back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's badass.
That's, I want you to, will you wear that if I get it for
wait,
you?
Wait, go up. Go back to the picture down. It's down a row. That right there. The guy, wait, no, up.
You know, ever since I turned my back on Tommy John, there's an opening for a birthday present for you, Dan.
Second from the right.
Is it a duster? Let's make this thing easy.
Oh, no, I wouldn't wear it. That's the thing.
You gotta give it at least four wears a year. One per season.
No, because you know what? I usually get high before I leave my house, and I would make it halfway down the block, and I'd be like, I gotta go.
Flip it out.
Yeah. The second the wind caught it, and I felt the wind in between my back and the duster, I'd be like, this is ridiculous. But if the end of the world happened, and I was able to have a new apocalyptic persona.
You get to pick your own post-apocalyptic outfit?
Fuck yeah, you do, dude.
Oh my God.
It's the best part about the end of the world.
I'd say that just takes us to the rest of the show today.
Well,
picking out. Let's online shop for our post-apocalyptic outfits.
Can I honestly say that I would adapt a lot of your current fashion techniques for the end of the world?
Post-apocalyptic?
Oh, fingerless gloves, first thing first.
So what it is, you're just afraid of society judging you for wearing them now.
I need society
you
to
You want
fall.
To wear them. You need society to crumble,
exactly.
And then you'll rise from the ashes.
I will feed
with
it.
A wallet chain and knuckle gloves.
Yes. Wallet chain, not so much, but the knuckle gloves, definitely.
Oh, really? Good. So when you find yourself up Schitt's Creek and someone's swinging a knife at you, you don't have a chain to catch that knife in and twirl them around.
If this is the reason why the whole time, you are a goddamn genius, Jay. Yeah.
You never know when I have to, like, catch the knife arm in the chains and then flip over his back.
Ooh.
And then choke him out with the chains.
What if you're on
and
a building?
I clipped him back on.
What if you're on a building, burning building, and you have to tango and cash that shit down an electric line?
That's very possible. Also, I can hold the two chains, and I can definitely what's that called?
Yeah,
zip line. I could zip line down to another building. Yeah, absolutely.
God, dusters are like if really. We talked about it on a Thursday's episode, but if I had really, like, male model confidence, I'd probably wear a duster.
No, that's the last time you'd want to wear a duster.
Why?
Because that's not, you want, duster's going pure machismo,
yeah. Is it the most
machismo? Those pretty boys are going to wear, like, those guys wear, like, vests and no shirts.
Is that the most macho jacket? Is the duster? I love that Jacob is nodding.
Well, that's the one.
Is
the
duster.
Tan leather duster is the jacket.
Tan leather.
Chuck Zito wore to
intimidate
me.
Is it still?
I forgot about the Chuck Zito incident with Jacob walking down the hall and Chuck Zito had a duster on with.
Full tan leather duster.
With a wife beater on, right?
No, the coat was on and he was just.
And he walked right through down. Jacob.
I've seen him wear the leather that Van Helsing before at the UFC.
Yeah.
As a guardian, he's wearing the Van Helsing with the big cape and everything.
Well, now picture it in
Chuck
this
Zito
narrow
gets
wall
it.
That you were pissed off at, and me having to go against the wall.
Because he wouldn't move out of the way at all?
No, he walked right down the middle.
Jacob, if now
straight,
if you would
and look straight through me to let me know.
If you would have been wearing a duster, Jacob, he would have respected you more. Now, I don't know if he would have lost respect when he sees that your duster's been hemmed to fit.
Yes.
But
hey, Charles, it's me. Jake. The snake.
Oh, sorry I was late, guys. Just had to fucking flatten Chuck Zito's face.
Hey, Chuck.
Hey, Chaz. Chaz Zito.
Turn around, you son of a bitch. Remember me? I was a mouse. Now I'm a goddamn rat.
Hey, it's everybody's hallway, faggot.
Yeah.
Move it or lose it.
Oh, these are like hot chicks and dusters. Come on, Christine. Why are you looking at it like it's a fashion magazine?
Men's.
Men's.
Type in the word men's, because now Christine's shopping for her own duster.
She goes, oh, I could like a duster this winter. Is that what you're... Is that,
I kind of just bought something that I guess is a little bit like a duster.
Not even sort of. She bought a jacket and a bag.
No, not my trench coat. It's something that you haven't seen.
Christine sometimes does really dress like she owns an arts and crafts store. It's just flowy, and she's like, what are you guys making over here?
She's like, I sit Indian style for everything.
Yeah.
Oh, I did save this.
Oh, boy. Whoa. Yeah, men's duster. Now that's
no, that's Burberry cashmere.
You see, you're keeping it all bougie.
I just did men in dusters.
That's a real duster.
Not men in dusters, men's dusters. Men in dusters.
But duster, yeah, so duster gets the tough stereotype.
Here we
and
go.
Trench coat gets the I'm going to show you my penis when you don't want to see it stereotype. Big difference. Those look like some fucking...
I'll tell you what, though. If we did an appearance, though, I mean, if our next Moon Tower is both showing up in two dusters.
Yes! If Comedy Central pays for it, of course we're going to take a duster.
We keep making Comedy Central pay for our stupid outfits.
Yeah, but Comedy Central...
If Comedy Central pays for half tops, we'll all wear half tops.
Oh, man, can you imagine? Can we get us
wearing dusters? First of all, we could definitely... Black Lou, I could already tell, 100% in on wearing a duster.
Are you in?
I mean, if everybody else is in, I'm in.
But you wouldn't by yourself?
Fuck no.
No, by himself. He'll get a jerk off.
Never.
What is he, Dark Tower?
Yeah. I would look like Hootie.
Yeah.
Idris Elba.
Do we all get tan ones? I don't want those ones.
No, I'm not. We're not fucking Matrix. Yeah. What are we doing?
You know what? That actually should be better if we dressed up all like Matrix. We'd look like an emo rock group.
It's like turtlenecks that end in dresses. Sort of.
Like Hellraiser?
Yeah, turtleneck dresses. Yeah. That's what it is. And tape, like tape, black tape all over us.
We are emo bonfire.
Should we go? Should we do that? Should we fight the scene next time into Austin and not go full blown Texas? Just go full blown goth, industrial goth.
Are you guys trying to go? You guys are trying to do some trench coat mafia shit?
Oh my god! Let's make Lou full blown steampunk.
Oi, oi, oi!
I did steampunk whiskey.
Oh man, we would look so dumb and so out of place, but so perfect for this show. Steampunk duster. Oh man, oh that would be great.
Oh, this steampunk? Oh, did we all show up steampunk? Like, we're going to come in like one of those cars that's like operated by a pedal and like an accordion thing?
Oh, it's total Gangs of New York style.
Yeah. Oh, dude, it'd be great. Oh, goggles? Oh, some Hellraisers?
Here's like all the jackets they sell at Trash and Vaudeville.
Perfect.
Kristen,
you can wear that thing with the leather.
That?
Yeah. What's that called?
It's a duster.
Yeah, well, that's from the movie, one of those Resident Evils. I guess it's loosely inspired by Resident Evil. It's a scene from Resident Evil. I'll tell you what. I'll tell you where I'm at in my mind.
Historical
It might be hysterical
realm.
Clothing realm.
Dude, I love that one. I know exactly which one you're talking
Lieutenant
about.
Lieutenant Esfeld?
Yeah.
I think that's where I'm going. I think that's what I'm going to play.
Yeah.
We'll be putting all these out at the Bonfire SXM on Twitter. Christine will not go to it.
Christine's just going her own way. Now
by the way, everything she's clicking on now is girl stuff.
Yeah. We've just inspired her. This is the only time we've looked at clothes, and Christine's let me go down this wormhole. It's like if Jay was the producer, and Christine was like, hey, can you bring up some porn? And Jay's like,
you're looking. Stop typing, stupid.
Oh, right here.
That's
a weird one.
It's a cool one, I think you meant to say.
Brown and denim.
Well, it's a girl one. We just found out the hard way.
Boo.
That hurts my mind more than anything.
Well,
I was so into it. That's the first time I've done that. I've walked into a lot of boot stores and been like, those? And they go, those are women's. I go, right. No, I'm saying, do they make those in dudes, though?
There you go. Those are ladies.
I mean, yeah. Does that designer do dude stuff?
Ah, you guys have good taste in lady boots. Oh, Jesus. Oh, I'm still in here.
More than once I've done that, I think. But, yeah. Isabel's in here. She's nodding her head, yeah.
Yeah, he likes girl shoes.
I don't like girl shoes.
I think you like girl
shoes. I've picked them. Shut up.
It's pink Skechers. You go, are these not? These aren't guys? Okay. Weird. Okay.
Hello Kitty Reebok pumps. No?
No.
Where you push the little hair bow?
So are we going to dress like that?
Yeah.
All right.
That's how I picture us.
Jacob on the right.
Yes. Jacob and Lou, full-blown steampunk. Black Lou, we got to make... What do we do with Black Lou? How do we dress him? Any thoughts?
Maybe Black Lou and I could go the Matrix route, and he'll go Morpheus, I'll go Neo, and then you're in the front right there.
Yeah.
Lou's in the back.
I just go leather pants, leather gloves, full-blown cape.
Yeah, full-on cape, and then I do the all-black bust-out, kind of like the Jenko one. See the one to the right, Christine, with Morpheus and Neo? Yeah, that one. Yeah, that'll be Black Lou and I.
Oh, yeah. It'll be real team-building, by the way, guys, when we have to oil me up so we can get me into my leathers.
Yeah, and also,
so you guys can pour me into my leathers as a team.
And when someone tries to attack us outside the venue because we look like fucking assholes.
We're going to be sweating so profusely immediately.
Oh, dude. We're not going to get from the hotel there. It's so hot at Moon Tower.
My monocle's going to be all steamed up. I'm going to be wearing a monocle, by the way.
Yeah, you sweating, walking into the venue going, is the AC going? I got to peel out of this thing real quick.
Oh, it's going to be things like, I mean, the pants are going to be like come down like backwards. You know what I mean? They're going to be flipping inside out because every step's like peeling off my skin.
They're just going to be sitting there clammy skinned and then you have to get back on it. It's a...
Whatever the smell of what'll be happening in my nuts that evening, bottle it.
Yeah. I'll tell you this. I'm going to take an Epsom salt bath after the show to wash off all that grime. We're going to take our first break. We'll be right back. It's the Bonfire.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Yeah. That's Chris Stapleton, everybody. We're doing all Duster Rock.
Why not? Dusters are awesome.
You love a good duster, bro.
I'm a duster guy. So what? Write me up for it. I don't care. Send me the goddamn tickets. The Bonfire. Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95.
That's where long hair comes in nice.
Yeah, dude. Long hair and a duster goes well. It goes well.
Yeah, long hair and a duster is a look right there. I'm a big, big fan.
Facial hair, too. Don't forget front face hair.
A big beard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Even with short hair, a big beard.
What do you think? Oh, Jacob, you're leaning forward like you were going to say, don't forget big bulging muscles.
Also, you got to be a big, strong man.
Outside of Blade, Wesley Snipes and Blade, do black dudes rock dusters?
That's not a
Booker T?
That's not a duster, though, on Blade. Blade, I would say it was more of a leather trench.
Okay, but in the vein of...
In the vein.
Harlem Heat did it for a little bit. I'm trying to think of other black dudes and dusters.
It's black. I'm telling you, you can find a lot. If you look up black bodybuilders, there'll be a ton of them wearing dusters.
How do you know that?
I bet you can find black bodybuilder duster. This is stepfather shit for sure.
Yeah, power your stepfather.
He used to have black guys and dusters come over and rape me. Yeah. That was his kink.
Those are babysitters?
He never touched me. He never laid a hand on me himself, but he would watch other...
He goes,
muscly right. Black gentleman.
You go, are you a sheriff? He goes, kind of, kid.
Sort of. I'm sorry. I'm sorry for what's about to happen to your partner.
I'm more of an outlaw.
Thug life. Spread your butthole. Hey, you have any pictures of that, Christine?
It's not coming up when I'm trying to do different Google things.
Black bodybuilder duster?
Looks like it's not a thing.
Buddy, it's a thing.
It's a thing?
Oh, yeah.
It's a subculture?
It's a subreddit.
Yeah, it's a subreddit. Black bodybuilders and dusters.
It's definitely, I've seen that look so many times. And they also sometimes relax their hair. Dude, black bodybuilders have no idea. If they don't shave their head, the black bodybuilders that have hair have no idea what to do with their hair.
Why?
Because they either have like a MC Hammer, like from the 19, like early 90s, or they have like straightened, like weird hair.
What do you find?
Like combed back like they're a fucking Isley brother.
Here comes Hammer. Did you not find anything, Christine?
No, I'm changing it to African American because when I type in black, it's just showing me black jackets.
You have to get politically correct?
Yeah.
You have to get politically correct in my Google search.
I have a special, a get well message to
the legend.
Ric Flair.
Yeah, he's in ICU.
Yeah?
Greatest wrestler of all time.
Well.
Yeah, he's number one, dude. Don't even try to. Yeah, fuck yeah, he is.
Wrestler?
Yeah, of all time. He's the best of all time.
Like, considering.
Ask anybody.
Wrestling moves?
Black bodybuilder in a duster. It really doesn't come up. You have to be in a duster jacket. And it's just like hot white ladies. It's so weird.
Wait. Of all time, the best wrestling, like wrestling moves and all that shit?
He's the best. He's the best pound for pound wrestler of all time.
It's an impossible thing to say pound for pound.
Not pound for pound.
It's a fake fight.
Yeah.
And he goes, I'll say pound for pound. You tell me who could beat him.
Yeah, no.
You tell me who could beat him pound for pound. I'll tell you who beat him. A script writer?
Most dangerous moves. No, I think he's the greatest of all time.
Really?
Yeah. I think his in-ring work, his promos, everything. He's number one. SummerSlam's this week. In fact, we forgot to put it on the plugs last week, but this Wednesday I will be doing Sam Roberts' live podcast from Highline Ballroom. Do you have the info on that, Christine? I think I said it. We'll do it. We'll plug it more
later. You're
going
to be on the same stage as the Feldog?
Oh, yeah. I'm going to kiss the stage because I know Feldog danced there.
That's pretty exciting.
But, yeah, I would. SummerSlam's this week. It's Sam Roberts Wrestling Podcast Live, Wednesday, August 16th at 8 p.m. Doors are at 6. So I'm going to go from here to there.
Are you excited for SummerSlam?
Yeah, I don't know.
Why?
I don't know if I'm going yet or not. SummerSlam's like the event for...
Where's it at?
It's at the Barclay Center.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's where it's been there for the past 3 years now.
Why?
I don't know, but it's great. It's awesome.
They have a residency for SummerSlam at Barclay Center?
They did it for a while at the Staples Center, and then they switched it to Barclay Center. So I wouldn't be surprised if they go back out west for SummerSlam in like the next couple of years.
Da, da, da.
But it's SummerSlam's like the card that all the wrestling fans want to see.
$50 for tickets to Sam Roberts Wrestling Podcast? All right, Sam.
Oh, no, it's $15,250. I think $50 you get to touch his hair.
So, yeah, for $50 you get to live with him for 2 nights?
Yeah, you get to really just, you get to be Sam Roberts' little brother if you pay $50.
For 50 smackers.
But yeah, but Ric Flair, I think, is the greatest of all time. It's hard, who would you say is better than him?
I'm just saying that those guys, look, all the wrestling people are going to fucking chop my nerd head off here. Mm-hmm. But, I mean, like a Rey Mysterio, like the thing that guy was able to do in the ring, though.
Yeah, but then his promos sucked, and he didn't sell a lot of tickets. He was cool to watch, but he's not, like, important. Like, Rey Mysterio is amazing. He's an incredible professional wrestler. But Ric Flair, like... You watch those old.
I mean, probably
Flair
The Rock at his best, probably.
That's an argument. The Rock, Stone Cold, but those guys will easily tell you that Ric Flair is the greatest of all time.
But they're just paying old man homage. That's like when you have to go,
dude. You got to remember
George Carlin, bro.
Yeah.
George Carlin.
But you got to remember, dude. He was Ric Flair came up during the territory days, going into gymnasiums and pissing people off, being like, "I got money and you are poor." The Killer Mike. Anybody out there? It's one of my favorite songs.
For 1 second, then maybe I'm second guessing myself that I am the greatest of all time, forever and ever.
But if you watch his old, Christine, bring up old Ric Flair promos, NWA Ric Flair promos. He's like in gymnasiums because wrestling wasn't that big, and he's just talking shit to all these angry poor people. And they're like, "Fuck you!" And he's like, "I got watches." It's like, I mean.
Yeah, I used to watch.
But I'm saying, like, Rey Mysterio was great, and he did a lot of awesome luchador moves and high-flying moves, but Ric Flair was, like, the complete package. Like, that dude was... What's up, Lutu?
Is he considered the best, almost like Jay-Z's considered the best rapper because of longevity and...
I mean, he's just like, yeah.
Talent.
I mean, I would say that. This is my personal opinion, but I've also heard, like, Shawn Michaels say that. The Stone Cold on his podcast has said that. It's pretty
Stone Cold's got a podcast?
Oh, hell yeah. You have never listened to it? It's pretty great. It's just with other wrestlers.
Really?
Yeah. Or and like wrestling stuff.
Well, let's see the promo.
Christine wants to talk about Ursher's dick.
Champion of the world, nature boy Ric Flair.
Lady! Woo! It is so hot to be humble when you're looking like Ric Flair. And the cap... Last night's events
And by the way,
I walked out of New York City.
I always love that his voice breaks sometimes. He's like, ah, yeah. But it's...
I always liked that I never found him to be like, he wasn't like a very good-looking guy.
Yeah.
Just like his whole thing was like how gorgeous he was.
Yeah, but that's pure confidence.
Do you believe he had any of that in real life?
They're doing a 30 for 30 documentary.
I know. I wonder what his wife looked like when he found her.
I don't know, but I bet
I'm sure she's a splattered mess now. But I mean, at the time, though, I bet she might have been nice.
Yeah, I mean, I think he was like, you know, he got famous in that circle, so he was probably like banging the hottest girls that were around.
But how long has he been married for?
That's one of his wives. He's had a couple.
Oh, what? That's not his wife. That's his wife now?
No, because I follow him on Instagram. I don't think that's his wife now. Anyways, Ric Flair in ICU. Hopefully he pulls out. They said he's, what was the article you had up? They said he was out of surgery?
Yes. Let me go back to
you play that.
Yeah. How's Leaping Lenny Poffalo doing?
Okay. He's dead. He died a long time ago.
No, he's not. He's alive.
Leaping Lenny Poffalo?
Leaping Lenny? Yeah.
I thought he died. Isn't that
Macho Man's brother?
Man's brother.
Yeah. Yeah. He's still alive.
You ask me how I know that?
Yeah.
That's what I know.
He was the genius.
Yes.
How do you know that?
They said that Ric Flair's in a medically induced coma and preparing for surgery. But then I just saw an article that said he was out of surgery. You just had an article up the city. Oh, here's an update. Flair is out of surgery and resting. Unclear how the surgery went. We're told Rick's family's by his side, and they're waiting to meet with doctors.
It was a heart thing, right?
Yeah.
Woo!
Woo!
My left ventricle is clogged. Woo!
That's how he does. That's how he, when he goes to the doctor. This guy really does. He's like, let me tell you something. I'm trying to get to the calls because,
oh, look, we had calls the whole time.
The whole time. Hulk Hogan has to be close to second best? Close to the best?
Oh. No way.
Well,
I'll argue that.
I mean, I was a Hulkamaniac when I was young.
Of course. But then you're talking only shit talk. His wrestling was the worst.
Yeah. I think Stone Cold, I mean, for me it goes Ric Flair, Macho Man.
David Allen Greer.
David Arquette held the belt in WCW.
Absolutely true.
So, you know, you could say
he's... I always say the best is Diamond Dallas Page. He's also my yogi.
Who? Diamond Dallas Page?
DDP.
Yeah, because he's changing it.
Bang!
Man, it sucks. I mean, he's 68, so for wrestling years, he's like 90. He's like 90.
Will you be sad if he dies?
Yeah, fuck yeah.
Sad.
Yeah, he follows me on Twitter. That was like one of the greatest follows I've ever had in my life.
Really?
Yeah, Ric Flair followed me last year around SummerSlam.
This guy's got some funny impressions. Woo!
He goes, he's got the jokes! Woo! I can't do a good Ric Flair. Black Machismo, Jay Lethal, this wrestler does an awesome Ric Flair impression.
Wasn't it Fez used to do Ric Flair, right?
Well, it wasn't an impression.
But look up Jay Lethal. Look up Jay Lethal's Ric Flair impression. What, he was living his lifestyle like Ric Flair? Is that what you're trying to say? Fez?
No. Oh. He did the impression, but it was like more like he just did that. He didn't sound like him.
Jay Lethal, Ric Flair impression. It's great. Look that up. Because I like when people can, when wrestlers do.
Other wrestlers?
Yeah. And he actually does a great Macho Man, Jay Lethal.
Oh. That's Dan Soder territory.
Dude, I have a video on my laptop of Jay Lethal and I doing Macho Man to each other.
You battle?
At the Iron Sheik Roast. It was in the bathroom of... It was in the green room of Caroline's.
Jay Lethal's another wrestler.
Yeah. He's an indie wrestler. And he was a character called Black Machismo.
In WWE?
No, he was in TNA. He was in some of the... TNA and then... indie circuits.
The black guy doing a Ric Flair impression?
Yeah, but he does.
It's a complex fellow. He's a little confused at times.
Wait till he gets on the mic, Christine.
Fast forward it.
Yeah, till he's on the mic.
Stand time. 16 time world champion. I know I'm the champion, but lady, I'm not taking you home with me no matter what you say.
He does like the kind of crooked tea thing, perfect.
Because I've said it before, to be shut up.
But Jay Lethal's great on the mic. But yeah, I mean, back to the point, I think Ric Flair is the best of all time.
Well, I want to get back to the point that I didn't think that was a good impression at all.
Yeah, I know, I was trying to bail him out.
I don't mean to... shit on your picnic there, but that was a... Now I want to hear his Macho Man.
His Macho Man's good.
Is it now?
Yeah, it is good.
I think you're trying to be nice to this guy.
No.
Does this guy owe you money?
Yeah.
You owe this guy money? Friend.
I owe him money. I owe him a lot of money.
He's a good friend of yours?
No. I've met him once. He's a very nice guy, though.
I think
his Ric Flair is good. I don't think she picked a good video. I'm not blaming Christine,
No, sure. Listen, I'd love to blame Christine with you, but I can't even put this one on her.
Listen,
that was bad. Let's give it another shot.
This is Ric Flair and...
Did I hear that punk right there say anything about the Four Horsemen?
That's pretty good.
The greatest group of men to ever grace God's green earth.
That was better.
How's Brutus the Barber Beefcake doing?
He's doing all right.
Luke checks back in.
He's like, hey, is Hillbilly Jim still kicking around?
How about Paul Orndorff?
Hey, Mr. Cowboy Wonderful? Bob Ace.
He's tough to look at now.
I saw a thing on the computer the other day that says Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff.
They tweeted us a picture of him.
Oh, yeah, let's see.
He was on WWE Raw's Legends Night last year, the year before.
Looks bad.
He's just skinny and he's got a big mustache.
He was jacked.
Paul Orndorff.
I liked him.
He used to be jacked.
Yeah, he was like, I mean, that was like clear steroids, right?
He got to be in, though, he was like, if you were famous in that one little segment of time, you got to be part of the WWF cartoon.
Yeah, Hulk Hogan and friends.
And the little dolls in the ring.
Yeah,
the rubber guys.
You got to be a rubber doll.
There's a recent picture of him with a mustache.
He looks like Anthony Cumia.
Oh, he doesn't.
Paul Orndorff. Mustache.
Oh, there it is. That was him when he came out. He looks like a crazy toy maker.
What if I told you the dolls were alive?
Tell you what, I got no problem with Paul Orndorff's stupid mustache.
Okay.
He was enormous.
Yeah.
He was like one of the first, like, super jacked guys.
That's why I asked, do you think it was steroids? Because there's a moment in the 80s where no one knew about steroids. Like, Lyle Zato, people forget about that, but that guy just did steroids and dominated and then just died of steroids because he was taking, like, horse testosterone.
Unproven that he died from steroids.
Bring up Lyle Alzado. But they're like...
He got cancer.
But how did... I don't know.
What? Are you holding back something?
Like, what if I told you? I have conclusive
evidence. I'm doing Diana Ball as you speak.
I'm D-balling. I'm rolling D-ball. Yeah, because steroids, there was a small time where you could just take steroids and fucking get away with it.
Yeah, old days.
It just says cancer.
Cancer.
After receiving rat, yeah, but bringing him up on steroids.
He got pneumonia. He died. I mean, brain cancer? But they always
died at 43.
Jesus.
Yeah. So
brain
what?
Lymphoma.
What's that?
And brain lymphoma.
Yikes.
Look at the connection between steroids and cancer and Lyle Alzado.
So he just got away with using steroids and then died of complications for lymphoma, which was
came out and started blaming steroids.
Which was diagnosed a year ago.
Lyle Alzado turned on steroids. Steroids didn't turn on him.
In which the athlete attributed to his years of taking massive doses of steroids to build and maintain a formidable physique.
Fuck him.
Whoa, dude.
No, I don't care.
Why are you so against...
I didn't like his character on My Two Dads.
Are you thinking of Mike Golick?
No.
Oh, that was Saved by the Bell, the college years, where he was...
Golick was in there?
Yeah, he was their RA.
Butkus was on something, too. What was Butkus on?
All these old football players would show up on 90s sitcoms. And
Lyle Alzado was in some sitcom. Maybe Butkus was My Two Dads. Butkus was My Two Dads.
Do you think they had freakouts on set because of CTE and just started smashing through fake walls?
Learning the ropes?
Learning the ropes.
It wasn't learning. I've never even heard of that before.
Hang Time.
Hang Time was who? That was...
Dick Butkus.
Dick Butkus? That basketball high school show?
Yeah.
Bring up Hang Time. I used to watch Hang Time. Man, the 90s, they just pumped out sitcoms.
I gotta see the theme.
Can you find it on YouTube? Mm-hmm.
The theme for Hang Time?
This is the age difference where you're too old.
Fuck you!
No, I'm serious. You're an old man. I'm sorry. I'm sorry you didn't get to enjoy Hang Time.
What?
Yeah, no.
What?
Turn down the TV. Uncle Jay's upset.
What?
But the 90s, they put out like five or six new sitcoms every year. And they were like, let's just see what sticks.
And there was like a lot of, they were like, the background of the title was always like Zubaz. It was like bright colors.
There it is. There's
like,
hang time.
Is this a TV show or a cereal commercial?
And where the high school hallway is, it's all Saved by the Bell. Look at how small those hoops are.
Everybody can dunk. And Butkus was in it? What?
I watched the show.
Nerdy kid, not on the basketball team. That's the one I...
The equipment manager?
Oh, the hot cheerleader.
No.
Kind of a bitch, alpha female. I remember her. Or is she the nerdy one?
Nerd chick.
Nerdy but approachable.
And the black.
That guy looks like Nico White.
The one black kid.
That they brought in from the inner city just to dominate in their white fucking school district.
The fucking show's called Hang Time. It's a show about basketball. Reggie Theus?
Reggie Theus? Reggie Theus?
Reg Theus?
Reg, you're popping up? Guys, don't worry. Basketball's only played with three people.
You know what, Reggie Theus? In his first act as coach of his white team, brought in his nephew.
Yeah, he goes, well, my nephew's coming here, so I have to be the coach.
He's like the choreographer of New Edition. He's like, you know what you guys need? My nephew, DeVoe.
He's going to put up 80 points a game.
Yeah. So Dick Butkus was in that? As a regular? Who was in My Two Dads? Type in My Two Dads, Dick Butkus.
You know they're rebooting everything. Why don't you and I reboot My Two Dads?
Because we have to reboot our two dads. Mine's a deadbeat. Yours is dead.
Mine's dead. What if we call it Deadbeat Dad? Where it's like a ghost
deadbeats.
There's like the ghost of my dead dad is roommates with your deadbeat dad.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. And
Living
they,
Gary and Dead Gary?
Yeah. My Two Dads. But it's like, a crossing over version of My Two Dads with Deadbeat Dads. I think we're on to something here. I think people would watch that.
Oh, I think so, too. By the way, My Two Dads did have Dick Butkus in it. What was Lyle Alzado? He wasn't that's not the only thing he was in. Go to IMDb and Lyle Alzado that shit.
Lyle, that should be a new term. Yo, you need to Lyle Alzado that shit. You're like, what are you going to do? You're like, I'm going to do it till it gives me brain cancer. Dude.
You know, I'm worried about those vapes, man. The scientists, they don't know. Dude, I'm going to Lyle Alzado these things.
Dude, I usually use a headset when I talk on my phone. Not me, man. I'll lay on my phone and talk. I'm Lyle Alzado and that shit.
I don't give a shit, dude. I'm going to Lyle Alzado my phone. I'm an adult.
I'm writing that shit out.
I'm an adult. Tape heads?
John Trapper, MD. I remember that.
What?
John Trapper.
You don't remember that because it was called Trapper John.
Damn it.
MD. I remember that.
I do remember Trapper, though.
Oh.
I don't remember what it was called.
The Bell That Saved Me? I watched that show. Did you?
Maybe I got the
doesn't sound like it.
Maybe I got the international knockoff. We were talking about that earlier. When I go home after school, it's just a different song. I can catch the bus on time. Welcome to Dutchland High School, also known as the Bell That Saved Me.
The Bell That Saved Me.
Well, because I was telling you about that. You brought up Steve Harvey's, his game show now.
I don't know how that's not going to be our whole second hour of conversation.
Which you briefly touched on it on Legion of Skanks, but
briefly.
You said you guys didn't get to the part that you wanted to get to, which was...
We just didn't... There's
Christine says the clips are unavailable right now.
There's a problem. I'm trying to get the DirecTV player to install because there's a problem loading the full episode, so I can try to
find some
clips.
We'll talk about first before you find the clips is, I was telling you that there's different international versions of The Office. I saw that on a piece they did on Steve Carell. Christine, if you could bring up, like, international offices, you'll see there's, like, a Japanese one, there's a Russian one, there's a Brazilian one, and they just do The Office. And you said Sal Volcano said that there's a different Impractical Jokers.
In some countries, they syndicate their show in most countries. Some countries, though, they just do their... It's called Impractical Jokers, and it's just different dudes.
That's so funny.
And I remember from being friends with Ben Bailey, that Ben Bailey had... So with Cash Cab, same thing. There was a Cash Cab After Dark in America, but then there was like, then they started doing like Cash Cab Cities here. There was like Cash Cab Miami was a different guy, Cash Cab Chicago, different guy.
Yeah.
But then they started doing overseas too, like different.
Cash Cab
pretty
Ireland?
Awesome, man. If you originate a thing like that.
Yeah.
Amazing.
So there's nine international versions of Impractical Jokers.
No, The Office.
Oh, The Office or Impractical
that
Jokers?
That was Impractical Jokers.
Nine different versions. That's hilarious.
So you want to see the guys, though, too?
Oh, yeah. What I like is, like, when you see, because The Office is based off of the Ricky Gervais British version.
I don't know how good the Impractical Jokers ones can be, because when I was in South Africa,
yeah,
I remember watching a show called the Sucker Squad.
Mm-hmm.
And they would trick you with things that weren't really, like, that big a deal.
Yeah.
And they showed there was, like, me and Jim Jeffries got way into the show. We watched it. We were in South Africa together. Just, like, pointing out. We kept doing this the whole trip because their prank show, the pranks didn't fool anybody. They were, like, not very good. So one of them was a guy who was wearing, like, a trench coat with a bunch of tea bags inside of it.
Okay.
And he goes, so he'd stop people in the street. He'd go, would you like to buy some tea? And he'd open his jacket up, and they'd go, no. I'm okay. He goes, you sure you wouldn't like to buy some tea?
We've talked about this at length before, but that's that international humor. And that's the stuff we were bashing at the Live, like, at Montreal stuff. We're like, what's funny about that?
He's like, what? Did I tell you about this show before?
Oh, no.
Oh. He's like, would you like to buy some? And they're like, no, we're okay. And then he goes, and they go, suckers. They call you a sucker.
Yeah.
And then point to the camera. And the people, when they look at the camera, are always kind of like, oh, there's... Okay.
Oh, you're taping
right.
us.
Like, yeah, like, all right, that's fine. Like, they never did anything to anybody. Like, is this your chair? And it's like, no, that's not my chair at all. He goes, you sure it's not your chair? And like, yeah, no, I'm sure it's not my chair. He goes, suckers! And then look at the camera, it's right over there.
A no prank prank?
Can we see if the sucker squad, South African sucker squad?
Americans are.
How have I never even thought to look this
maybe
up
just better at tricking people. I think we're the best at tricking people into they believe shit, and then we're like, I mean, the prank show really did. The prank show, did it originate in America? Because it feels.
God, it should stop though. The prank shows. The Impractical Jokers figured out the most unique, great way to do this.
Yeah, between friends,
you're not, but you're also not relying on people.
Yeah,
I mean, you need them to come and be part of these things, but like the humor's in the guys.
Yeah.
You trust those guys to be funny, and then those situations will work out. When you leave it to the people, like, oh, it's the worst.
I love when they try to go serious with prank shows, and they're like, we put these people in a suit. And they had that, like, what would you do on ABC? And it'd be like a guy hitting his kid, and you're in the park. And you're like, dude, you have to go to such a level where you're like, I'm going to fuck this dude up. I'm going to fuck this guy up. This guy's hitting his kid. You walk up, you go, hey, motherfucker. And they go, you know what? You're on an ABC show right now. You're like, cool, then I'm going to fight you because I have all this rage that's boiled up inside of me.
We're taping it.
Yeah, you know. Don't you put your hands on him.
A full-blown choke?
Yeah.
No, we're doing I got to go.
Fucking monster. You're a fucking monster.
I'm the producer. Turn around.
If you could please. There's a license agreement.
Yeah, there's just two. You're just gonna fucking get. You're gonna get the shit kicked out. I don't know. That's when they take prank phone call or prank video shows where they're like, stop. Don't make it serious. Because then someone's gonna get killed. And there's also those guys. We've talked about these guys before on the show that like go up to dudes in the hood and just talk shit and try to get punched in the face.
Oh my god!
Like that's like prank thing where he's like, "There's a camera. There's a camera." And you're like, "You want to die?"
Yeah, while you're jogging away or sprinting full speed and yelling, "There's a camera!"
Boy,
We've
talked about that, right? Those guys. Yeah, I thought we had an episode where we talked about them a couple of years ago.
The guys who fucked with the people in the hood.
Yeah, where they just go up.
One time, a guy's gun falls out.
Yeah, and then that guy. Like, oh, but then they want to be the victims. I don't know. I don't like, yeah.
Is there a black office? Did we find that out?
What do you mean?
Well, all these office, different offices.
Yeah, I don't think they're going by race, though. There's not, it's like, can we get on?
I mean, there was a place where it's like Congo office.
No, like West African office?
It's called the Hut.
Yeah. Yesterday was a good day. The warlord did not cut off our supplies, and Jim was all like, you're going to go out or not? I'm like, what?
Why is there no...
Because it's all subtle. You know, it's all subtle reactions in the mockumentary style. Like, so today I realized my son came home from school, so he has not a child soldier. And then I was like, you still going to do your homework?
There's still some racist guy watching at home. You're going like, Jesus Christ, they take over every gun.
Every show.
Do you have international offices so we can see? Christine... I feel like we're sending her on like 20 different things at once. Like, bring, oh, what's this?
She's yeah, still, this had a bunch of broken links, so I'm going to try to find the other ones on a different site, but there's one that does work.
She's like, I can't find Black Office, but I did find a really great duster for myself.
She goes, this one's like sleek, but sexy.
Well, I can't find, it's weird, I can't find anything on Sucker Squad, and it says that he, there's a guy, Mark Pilgrim, that I guess became a radio personality, and there are things that say that he was part of who tricked South African singer Robbie Weasels into making a fool of himself. I guess that was the biggest episode, but it doesn't
Robbie
tell us
Weasels?
What
it is. Not Robbie Weasels? Who the fuck is Robbie Weasels?
I don't know, but...
Let's go in this hole. Let's go in this hole.
I'm trying to find all
we got more than an hour. We're 4 days a week now. We can chase these fucking ponies. We can chase...
So this is German. Oh, wait, no.
No, there it is. Yeah, no, that's...
This is France.
Oh.
C'est une chanson que j'ai composée, hein. De toute façon, je joue que ce que j'écris, donc...
Oh, quack, quack, quack.
J'entends pas bien, c'est pas déjà pas...
So I know which, this is an episode that's been in all the offices.
Hey, petite fille, je débat...
They just remake the episodes?
Really? Yeah, but what's so funny is... In the British version, David Brent's playing a guitar. In the American version, Steve Carell's playing a guitar, his character. And this one, he's playing a keytar because they had to really French it up. We're like, what is it? A wackier way to play the guitar? What about the piano guitar?
Perhaps make it more silly. Yes.
They just keep having pratfalls.
Pratfall!
Wow, they just redo the episodes. They just redo the episodes.
Yeah.
They just redo the episodes? That's so stupid.
But this was the same.
If they're going to redo the episodes, why don't you just...
No, this is just a song.
You know what, though? America made it. But they didn't redo the English episodes, did they?
Yeah, they did. That's the same from the same episode of the team building exercise.
Wow, that's so lame. I never watched The Office.
I watched it, yeah. My buddy had it in college on DVD, and we watched it, and I thought it was funny.
We could all tell I didn't watch The Office because of that that lady.
Remember oh, that? Yeah.
I did get very invested into Jim and Pam's relationship. Well, it did hit me.
I don't even know what that means.
Well, there's two characters.
Is it the Luke and Laura of shows I don't care
can
about?
Can we go to Brad Weasels, who's in South Africa, who got tricked into sitting in the chair?
Did you sit down in the chair? Ah, sucker!
Suckers!
You ruined my life!
The guy sits down. You just...
Who's your girlfriend here? Are you cheating? Suckers!
Suckers! You just destroyed my life! I can't go home now!
You destroyed your life! Suckers!
So who is this guy?
Oh.
Yeah.
He looks like David Arquette on a bender.
You mean world heavyweight champion David Arquette?
Yeah. He's sweating. You're not supposed to sweat in the... What?
Is this, like, serious?
Well, I'm more, what's he singing? I think they speak English in South Africa.
Afrikaner.
Oh, you think he's speaking, really? There's no word for hijack in fucking Africa?
No, there's... He's speaking English now.
No, he wasn't. He just, the word hijack came out in English. That's it.
It sounds like he's speaking...
That's what you can always tell what words they don't have words for English.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not a fucking linguistics expert, but I think they speak Afrikaner.
No, I'm not...
Oh.
Wow, you got very...
No, but I don't... I'm confused.
Very personal there.
I don't know what they were speaking.
He was speaking another language, but the word hijack was in there. Whatever he's speaking, there's no word for hijack.
Afrikaner.
I'll tell you what. This video is very similar to the Smoke With Me video by Michael Rage. Stupid people!
Oh, dude, that's... So, is that... what language is he speaking?
Michael Rage.
Afrikaans. Afrikaans? Is that it?
Maybe.
Maybe he was speaking Swana.
I just like the low quality of international videos. That's why I was confused, because I was blown away by the low quality.
It looks exactly like Smoke With Me.
Yeah.
If you watch the video, I mean, I'm going to tell you shot for shot.
Go back to the, it looks like a shot on a handheld.
Look, he's dancing here. Go to YouTube, bring up Smoke With Me by Michael Rage. Rage Boo. Ring en Bobby staan en chat bij die applicie. Dat is vol.
Anybody listening know what language this is?
I can't believe.
I don't know how to figure this out.
This isn't popular, right? This is like a thing that we found on a dude's page. Because this seems...
I just Googled Robbie Weasels because that was, when I looked up Sucker Squad, that was the name that came up.
About him, his life getting ruined?
About him making a fool of himself.
I mean, did Sucker Squad make this video? Is that what's going on?
Did they convince him to release this?
Sergey, smoke with me, Michael who?
Mike Rage.
Mike Rage.
Just do Rage Boo on YouTube.
The Mike Rage?
Oh, dude.
No, we've watched the video before.
I know, but I'm telling you, these videos are so lined up.
Aren't you in the... Were you supposed to be in the video?
I was not in the video because I wouldn't let him cut in front of me one time at open mic.
Oh,
and he informed me that if I didn't let him get up in front of me, that I was going to be removed. I would not be welcome on the Smoke With Me video.
When was this filmed?
Years and years ago. Now, just do Rage Boo as a person. Look. One word. Let's see if we can find this. I think this is all worth it. See, there he is. That easy.
He bit this from Robbie Weasels.
Oh, snap. Look at that, bro.
This guy is so Philly, dude.
When will be back, it. Man? What's taking him so long?
Yeah. This is shot with the same camera.
I was in Baltimore this whole weekend, which got some juicy accent. Some great accent going down there. Yeah, we watched before. I told you, that guy right there in the Giants shirt owes me about $3,000.
To this day? Oh, that was the guy that did... Is that the one you did the show with?
Sweet Cheeks.
Yeah.
That's what they call me. Who calls him a weed man?
Yeah, he owes me like $3,000 probably.
Dove, he's got the Eagles thing in the back.
Oh, dude. He tucks in his Sixers jerseys to his jeans.
That's a classy look.
Like, he shows what an old guy he is doing this.
Is that Philadelphia formal?
Oh, dude. But you see, am I right? Is this not the same video? Is this Robbie Weasels?
I get farther in it. Ah, his dancing is...
I'm smoking, baby, but I don't do love.
By the way,
700 views.
Jacob's real into it.
Oh, wow,
he does tuck in that fucking.
Does it have 700 views? Really?
796.
I'm easily 500. I'm easily good for 500 of these views.
When the trees are in my system, and am I ever gonna
miss
everything? Baby, I'm
not
gonna
go golden
blunt. Can't have none. I smoke all
yours. The sound engineer had to be like, yeah, he had to be do the fucking John C. Reilly from Boogie Nights where he's clapping back. Yeah, go to Robbie.
Dude, look at his regular old chicks just hanging out in the back.
Really hot chicks.
But then pause this and go to Robbie Weasel.
Oh, yeah.
He's got hotter girls because they're international. He might have enough. It's shot a little nicer.
Okay, but Tony...
Oh, Robbie Weasel and Lou Ours. Is he speaking French? What the fuck is he speaking? It's French.
I always think it's Robbie Wessels.
You're right. This shot nicer. Is he like Weird Al Yankovic over there? These feel like they're joke videos.
I mean, that guy in the back.
It does feel like it.
They are. They're jokes. Had they ruined his life on a prank show?
I am the jokester, not to be made jokes of.
I need to find out what language his website's in, and then we can probably figure out what he's speaking.
Hello. I was ruined by a shitty prank show.
I think Afrikaans is right because it's Dutch-inspired, and this looks like Dutch.
Gone Koop van Dag nu.
Rolling Stone says, Ek is trans de slen in die. Afrikaans is Groot.
Let's find out more about him. We'll take a break and come back with more knowledge of South Africa's smash success.
It's Afrikaans.
Afrikaans?
You're right.
I'll argue that when we come back, I'll be speaking fluent Afrikaans.
So you think it's like pig Latin? You can learn it?
That easy, everybody.
Easy.
It's the Rosetta Stone. I'll figure it out in the next 5 minutes. We'll be right back. It's the Bonfire.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
I respect white...
Purple rain.
I respect white yoga, but that kind of bugs me.
Purple rain.
It's Duster Rock on the
purple
Bonfire.
Purple rain. See you later.
purple rain.
And now back to Hee Haw. That's
take me down to the paradise city where the great
man. If you just want to do a cover band,
country it up.
Oh my God, it takes such little effort
to just country up a popular pop song.
Four chords.
Living in a Barbie world. I'm a Barbie girl. I'm so happy.
I'm blue, bottom, be, bottom, 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 blue, bottom, 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 be, bottom, blue.
Rico, Rico, Swole.
And this is a beat, oh, you can touch. Bing, ding, ding, down.
Down, 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 down. That's Big J. Everson. I'm Dan Soder. This is Comedy Central. I'm Sirius XM 95.
I want to go way more hardcore with that.
Start with
slam, dip, 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 dip.
Let boys be boys.
Gotta let boy be boys.
That's totally a great cover. How is no one country covered Onyx?
Slam, boop, 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 boop.
Let the boys be boys.
Gotta let boy be boys.
OPP, yeah, you know me. Yeah, you know me.
You been on me.
I'd fuck your wife, you fat motherfucker. Get money.
I know you like to think your shit don't stink. Get a little bit closer, see the frames always smell like poo-poo. Roses always smell like poo-poo-poo.
Dusta Rock takes us to, I don't know that, how you jumped to this, but we were so excited to talk about this last week, and then we just completely forgot about it. But Usher is in court.
You remind me of a girl
that I once knew.
Once knew. That was the girl I gave herpes to.
She was a big girl.
Wow.
Usher's in court. Plaintiff claims that vaginal and oral sex exposed them to herpes.
Yeah.
Wait, so they didn't get herpes?
No.
So you could sue someone for just coming close to grazing a bullet?
Yeah, well, that's this girl.
I'm going to take so many girls to court. I got a backlog of about 15 girls I'm about to fucking bleed their bank accounts.
Oh, yeah.
I go, hey, I danced with the devil. I mean, I got out alive, so I wasn't going to bring it up again, but now that I got a case.
Oh, my God. The girl who's very outwardly accusing him is really, it's just, you would never expect that to be
what
Usher's.
She looks like a McDonald's manager. Like, I'd be like, hi, I'm number 40. I'm 43. You guys jumped ahead to 48.
Dude, she tells
that's not my problem.
She tells the story of him.
Do you have the video? Do you have the video?
Back? Oh, yeah. The press conference, dude. I've heard, like.
There's a press conference?
She's like,
and me and my girl, you hang, man. We were probably going to go to Waffle House afterwards, get some bacon.
Hey, I hope it really
gonna
is.
Get some waffle.
I don't think
gonna
it's.
Get some chicken. Oh.
It looks like.
To celebrate my birthday.
This looks like a Glow press conference.
It does.
Look at the fucking money hungry lawyer next to her.
I know.
Say this.
What's her name?
Quantasia.
Well, you wonder if her lawyers laughed in the George Lopez white voice, and they go, Quantasia, more like money made you. All right. We got ourselves a case. We're going to bleed that dancing asshole dry. I hope Hotlanta's
Quantasia, more like this cunt won't phase you. Don't even sweat it, Usher. You don't even have to show up to this one, bub.
I'll tell you this. You just go take a sexy bath.
Just go take us.
I know you love.
There's also an Usher reaction video.
Oh, well, let's watch the press conference video.
Lou said to restart it because he thinks he says something.
A former defensive tackle, Gilbert Brown, addressing Usher.
The Usher reaction is going to be fake. I could already tell you it's going to be fake.
Okay, well, let's just watch this.
This is very, very real.
I went to a concert of his with some friends.
There's not better. Can you find better audio, like, from the microphone? Because I don't like I'm listening in, like I'm cleaning the hallway, and I'd be like, what's this bitch talking about?
By the way, her name's Quantasia Sharpton. You think it's Al Sharpton's niece?
I mean, that would just be too perfect, so probably no.
That'd be so great.
She also has tattoos on her body the way when you're a little kid and you get fake tattoos and you put them on and you're happy about them.
Need more room.
She goes,
I did not get herpes. However, his super sweet sugary semen did flare up my diabetes.
Do you think she went in trying to get a kid and then was like, well, I went face to face with herpes. Did you find other video?
Yeah, I don't know if it's going to be any better.
Usually they don't mic these things well.
Oh.
In my experience.
All right.
I went to a concert of his with some friends a few years ago to celebrate my birthday.
Sure,
I was wearing a birthday crown, and because of that, I was selected to go backstage before the show. Later, a security guard picked me up and asked me for my number.
He did what?
He told me Usher had seen me backstage.
He asked me?
And was interested in me.
Pause it.
After
he goes, she told me Usher's moving up a weight class, and he wants me in a tune-up fight.
He asked me if I want to come backstage. A security guy told me Usher's looking to fight heavyweight and wanted to get in the ring and see what I'm about. So I went backstage, and I sucked his shit. Then, next thing I know, finds out.
That lawyer next to her at the Bonfire SXM, we'll tweet out the picture, that lawyer next to her looks like such a monster. That icy woman looks like she puts a wig on a mannequin's head and then goes to bed and goes, do not touch me, Richard.
You're doing great quantation.
He goes, I know, Barbara. I know we're, our sex life's dead. She's like, yes, it is. And I have a press conference tomorrow. Finally getting that Usher motherfucker.
He goes, I'm trying to prep Quantasia, so I need you to bear with me.
Okay. Once this case is settled, we might be able to make love again.
What if they ask me all kinds of crazy questions?
What if Usher show up?
What if Usher show up? He start dancing, girl. You know I can't say mean things about him. He start dancing.
That's how he gets out of it. He just shows up and starts dancing all sexy. He's like, you remind me of a girl. She's like,
yeah, bring this. You reminded me of that time I fucked your butt.
Do you remember times when you got so close to my dick wounds?
Yeah. Remember I told you I was covered in grown hairs?
That's what he told her? He goes,
you're an idiot for believing that shit.
He goes, no, baby, look at my neck. You see those bumps in my neck from shaving? It's just like that, but down on my dick. Yeah.
Herpes!
I didn't know you found out somebody didn't disclose a STD that you could sue him.
Well, dude, Michael Vick.
From the windows to the walls!
Mike Vick used to do that in Atlanta under the name Ron Mexico. He'd go out and fuck women and say his name was Ron Mexico and he had herpes. He'd just give them herpes.
Is that a real thing?
Dude, that's 100% a real thing, and why anytime I see a guy in public, I saw a guy wearing an Atlanta Falcons jersey that said Mexico on the back, and I was like, you're hilarious. You are funny. That's great.
What's the name? What, Ron Mexico?
Yeah, Michael Vick went by the name Ron Mexico when he played for the Falcons, and he'd go to clubs and fuck women and give them herpes and then just dip out. Also, if you're dumb enough to fuck a guy named Ron Mexico, you should get herpes.
Really?
Yeah. He got hit with a sexual lawsuit. What year is this from? 2003. Yeah. Claiming that Michael Vick gave her herpes, a Georgia woman is suing the NFL star for negligence and battery. According to the below lawsuit, Sonia Elliott, a 26-year-old healthcare worker, was infected with a sexually transmitted disease in April of 2003 after unprotected encounter with Vick at the athlete's Duluth, Georgia home.
Nice to meet you. My name's Pussy Weeping Wounds.
Yeah. Hi, I'm Craig Spain. Don't mind my dick bleeding. It's totally normal where I'm from. Elliot's lawsuit alleges that Vic had used the name Ron Mexico, and in a related court filing, her lawyers are seeking Vic's admission that he used the Mexico alias and perhaps other fake names.
Mr. Mexico? Perhaps. Mr. Mexico, why does your dick meat look like homeless gums?
Oh, no. Honey, you, fuck you. I gotta introduce you to my friend George Poland. He cool as hell. Gave me herpes, but he cool.
He cool. Besides that, though.
So yeah, I thought this was from 2003. That's crazy. I remember reading that online. That was 14 years
AKA
ago.
AKA Ron Mexico.
Yeah, so if you got a Falcons jersey, put Mexico on the back of that 7. Boom, instant joke. And also a good way to warn a woman you have herpes.
Like, I was wearing the jersey.
Yeah. Skeet, you're infected.
It is to the windows, to the wall. Close your eyes. Windows, to the wall. Seriously, cover your eyes and maybe just wear a tarp like a Gallagher fan. Windows, to the walls.
I'm not going to lie. My juice is live.
From the windows. walls. Honestly, treat this jizz like battery acid. To the walls. Do you remember, oh, that's something. Oh.
Do you remember that game?
Off my pussy balls.
Do you remember the floor is lava? We'll just act like my dick is lava.
When I come, honestly, run. Windows.
Go back to the press conference for Usher. He should have just used a fake name.
They really don't tell people. I've had friends with herpes. They just don't tell people. They hope for the best.
That's that's entrapment.
I mean, Usher looks like he could fucking, honest to God, like, grease up her torso and just tit fuck her with his whole body.
Damn.
Just coming in hot, just slip and slide right through her tits.
He goes, do you want to slip and slide tit fuck?
You remind me of he's just tucking his hair under a swim cap.
He's just humming it. All right, time to oil you up.
All right, coming in hot. He goes through a wall, halfway through a wall.
I call this a butterball tit fuck. Hit play.
I got a call from Usher. On the block number.
Girl, you might want to get tested.
No. I really wish we could find good audio of this because it's hard to listen. I know you're trying. Christine, I believe in you. Just hit play.
Last night I may have given you a hot batch.
Here, Robbie. We spoke for a while, and then you just left. Sexual contact. He never warned me about any STDs. It was just after.
You know what? That is vague. She's like, she doesn't want to explain. She goes, I was like, Usher, will you please have sex with me? And he was like, nah. But he stood up. He straddled me with his legs and dropped his nutsack in my eye sockets. Yeah. He laughed out loud. He yelled the word Ray-Bans and ran off. Now, I did not, in fact, get herpes. However,
I was in the room with herpes. I saw them.
If any of y'all ever had nuts in your eyes, I got to tell you. It's exhilarating.
Yeah, because she does judge. She, you know, it's funny as she goes from like, we had conversation and then engaged in sexual contact, where it's like, it was 75 minutes of me convincing him that no one would find out.
Yes.
That's what,
come on, I'm holding back here. Why don't you give me a little bit of something? I can't get a little bit of something. It's my birthday. You see, I'm wearing a crown.
Yeah.
All right, technically it was my birthday 3 weeks ago, but that's my birthday month.
It reminds me of Deuce Bigelow, male gigolo. He's like, did someone say steak? Oh, no, I'm all excited. What were you saying, Christine?
I feel like this isn't getting talked about at all. It says he had oral sex with a male who was also suing him.
Wait, what?
Everybody's talking about this fat girl. Nobody's talking about the dude.
That's how fat she is.
Yeah. Well, allegedly he had two.
She's so fat, I'd rather just fuck two guys instead of us.
That's how you break down. That's the herpy math. At least one of the two women who are suing him, where's the part about the man?
Right here. He had oral sex with a male who was also suing him.
Oh.
All right. Well, Usher goes both ways.
I guess now we go around the room and ask the question. Do you let Usher blow you if he has a canker sore? Lou?
Fuck no.
Black Lou?
Hell no.
All right. Jacob?
Big no.
Yes.
Christine, you dive right in that herpes pool. For that backstage access.
I'm going to look you in the eyes and ask you my question when you ask me this. Mm-hmm. If I would, what year Usher?
Okay.
Good. Ooh.
Well,
it might be the little You Got It Bad.
That's a 2003?
He's a little young there. No, let's go with like a...
So is I.
Yeah.
I'm younger than him, so it's my age then and his age now. Is he in the silk pajamas?
Just for the record, he's not going to have a canker that long ago. You think he got these herpes young? Because it's just going to be coming out now. It's saying he blew a guy?
It says he had oral sex with a guy, so, you know. I mean, I don't know if that's giving or receiving.
Look at those nostrils. Fit a couple of dicks up there, probably.
You should go to his... Do we have the response video?
Usher's response?
He goes, oh, man, you guys saw her? Oh, shit. I was in a bad place. Well, let's finish. I mean, let's...
I know it's a little hard to listen to. I'm trying it's to hard find to listen other to. That's, audio clips. Yeah. And
I want you to hear the fact she says she does not have herpes.
I just came out here to embarrass this motherfucker.
He
says he's going to call me back. Look how big my panties is. Look how big these panties is.
She puts them over the lawyer and goes, don't touch me with those. Do not touch me with those.
My lawyer can wear these as a raincoat.
She goes, please. I was supposed to be a local news anchor, and instead I'm just a cutthroat lawyer.
My blood's mostly sauce.
Can you, you don't, either one, the audio stinks.
Yeah, just play it. Well, the newer one was better.
I never heard from him again. When I first heard reports that he had herpes, I couldn't believe it. I had a child a year ago, and I knew I was negative. But I contacted Lisa Bloom to find out what my rights are as a woman. Although I am negative, I was upset by the reports because I would have never consented if I would have known.
First off, can you just stop?
Yeah, you would have.
I just noticed that the microphone is 10-10 wins. The fucking AM, the 10. She was going to get about the weather updates. He's like, that's who you're sponsoring the press conference. It was fucking public radio weather updates.
Dude, this just in. I don't know. We got nothing today. It's a slow news day. A fat chick said Usher fucked her and almost gave her herpes.
Dude, this chick would have literally squirted his herpes onto her hot dog and eaten it. I mean, she doesn't
Thank
give
you,
a shit.
Usher. Oh, but baby, you know, I don't care. Why don't you put that herpes out there on my burger?
So she fucked him, didn't get herpes, and he's suing because she was upset by it.
Yeah, huh?
I mean, I
that lawyer is a fucking
a will,
asshole.
No, nah, she could. Money.
That lawyer really is evil.
No, nah, she got a hood pass. I'm going to pull a wig off if I don't win. This big man hope we win.
There's
oh,
no...
you in the hood, man.
She just starts hood fighting her.
Oh, you know, this is the lady who does. She shows up at, like, the hood where this girl lives at 6 months. It's like when the recruiter came and talked to Ricky and Boys in the Hood.
Yeah.
She was confused. I'm here to see Quantasia. Oh, you is you? Yeah, that's a mighty nice purse you got there, Miss Lady.
Yeah.
She goes.
Well, I think we have a case.
You think we have a case? She goes, yeah, I bet you do. And then her mom comes back and goes, Nate, what you doing talking to this young lady like this? You need a, you know she's a lawyer for Quantasia. Quantasia! Yeah. Your lawyer here! Apologize to that bitch.
Hey. Oh, wow, you here? Did you bring Wendy's like I asked you to?
She looks like a realtor. Her lawyer looks like a mean realtor.
Jill Jacobs,
she goes,
helping you find a house in the greater Malibu County area.
I'll slit a fucking throat for a two-bedroom that's affordable for you. I mean it. I am a fucking go-getter. Go to the Usher.
Why? But just to come out like this and do this seems very, very bizarre to me. To come out and be like,
I think she's suing for money. It's not.
But
bizarre.
She doesn't even know what's the timeline. She said she had a kid a year ago. All this is coming out now about us.
So wait, did she, so she has that body because she had a kid? Do we have a younger picture? Did she?
I'm sure she was.
Was there like a herpes support group? Is it only come out? Has he been doing this for a long, long time? And there was like a support group randomly in L.A. and it was kind of like everyone's like a herpes support group, but everyone's like, I don't want to talk about how I got this famous person. He goes, what? I got mine from a famous person.
Yeah, no,
who'd you get it from? Because, well, I mean, mine, a famous person, I'm a guy, and a famous person sucked my dick, so you probably wouldn't even know who I'm talking about. All right, we'll all say it on three.
Does it start with a U? And I'm not talking about Underdog the cartoon. Because I know the guy that voiced him, and I sucked his dick, too.
Oh, it's not Underdog? Oh, I'm out then. Yeah. I thought it was Underdog.
Sorry, I'm gone, boys. Homosexuality used to be for cartoonists and their queer voiceover actors. I sucked off Underdog. I blew Fred Flintstone. I fucked them all. Wile E. Coyote. What a real queer that one is.
Can you hit play on the response video?
I went to a concert of his with some friends a few years ago to celebrate my birthday.
Oh,
wait a minute. Oh,
that's a meme.
You got it. You got it bad.
I don't think he's put any press out on it. Said that on one of the articles
not.
It said you couldn't reach him.
Itchy.
Oh, what does 50 Cent say? Everyone's just making fun. It really is just like the worst thing.
This trip thing. I know that nigga said, I'm checking my paperwork today. I get out this motherfucker. I'm going to kill that motherfucking bitch. I'm going to find her motherfucking house. I'm going to find something, some information from my paperwork to get this bitch. The bitch from the mall, man. You're never gonna forget that shit, trust me.
Maybe I'll spend Christmas in jail.
I don't even know what the hell he's talking about.
It have nothing to do with...
My name is Contagious Sharpton. I love Usher's artistry and music. I went to a concert of his...
I mean, she's suing because she just wants... This is her excuse to tell the world, if it happened even, that she fucked Usher. Because, oh! Oof! Is this them? Is this her at the concert? Oh! Oh! Oh!
Oh, dude, that's great. Is that really her?
It's... Oh!
They go, guys, bad news. Usher needs to have his hips reload.
You think Usher just loves fat girls?
Yes.
I mean, black guys do love fat girls.
Hasn't the man suffered enough?
I don't... Is this her, though?
It would almost be more funny if it's not. He just, like, loves having these beasts come give him lap dances.
I like when these bitches get on top.
He goes, hey, I think tonight in Chicago I'm going to have a stampede. And they go, the new guy, the guy that's new, the touring crew, is like, what does that mean? And they go, Usher gets a big girl out of the studio.
It really looks like if you cut this video, the half, and just showed her body and his legs coming out, it looks like when the house lands on the witch in Wizard of Oz.
Hey, nigga. You know, I had to call you and tell you ain't shit.
That's how I feel right now.
What I'm saying is I just wish you had thought about everything before you did.
These are all parody videos of it.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, that's a tough thing. It's a tough thing for a girl to
black
come
people
out.
Black people love overacting in short Instagram video clips.
But they make the best. Some of my favorite like vines were black dudes overacting.
I thought you were going to say something like, no, but they make the best peanut butter.
What?
So, find black facts. Like, oh, yeah, they overact for sure. But, you know, let's not forget they make,
let's also
the street
not
light.
Forget that Usher. This was just like a fat girl coming out being like, I fucked Usher. That's it.
Yeah. Really? Oh, you know, we should have done that. Let's hold a press conference, and I'll talk about why Pam Anderson owes me because she never told me she had, that she had hep C. And I'll be like, did you have sexual contact with her? I'll be like, no. But I've thought about doing that a lot, and she never even
Can
told
I be
me.
Your stuffy?
She never even told me she didn't have hep C.
Can I be your stuffy lawyer next to you?
Yeah.
Like, Mr. Oakerson would like to make a statement. The plaintiff at the time was Pamela Anderson, now Pamela Lee. Back to Pamela Anderson. Jay would like to make a statement.
First and foremost, I will say when I met Ms. Anderson, it was my birthday. So I was wearing a crown. So that's why I think I was singled out here. We were all at a party at Scott Baio's house. And thank you. And
yeah, I know. No, I know Charles.
She passed out unconscious on a crazy diving board accident. She whacked her head. She was having culottas. I went over her. There was no one around. I very, very well could have had my way with her. And I did not do it. And thank God, because this bitch, if you don't mind me saying, never told me that she had hep C.
How much money is this lady asking for? Because she's going to get crushed in court.
Ugh, she better hope.
You're leaving. You can really just sue for whatever the fuck you want now.
But that's it. She wants. If he showed up again in her life, he's like, "Hey, you want to go one more again?" She'd say yes.
She'd be like, "You're right.
You know I'm going. I mean, I can't not get it twice, right?"
I'm down to double dip that stick.
Well, clearly I'm immune to it, so I obviously am the one that will not get it. I am the daywalker.
What do you think about all this racist Clint Eastwood?
Damn. Smack. Oh, look at Debadu waving at Jacob. Wait, what is this? I need some money. Oh, look at what Christine just found. These damn.
I knew it. You can't get these mud ducks their day in court without trying to get some kind of a scam going. Fast twitch muscle fibers want their money.
I need some money. Mother of three, 21, who is suing Usher for having sex with her and not saying he has herpes, revealed her cash was on Facebook a week before filing the lawsuit.
Ooh. I knew that flat nose had a game of her sleeve.
She spoke at a press conference in New York on Monday announcing the lawsuit. It really was terrible. The 21-year-old said she had sex with the singer after attending one of his concerts. So she had sex with him recently, or he's a bigger criminal than that. You all right, Jacob? I saw you dart over there.
Well, anytime in the last 4 years.
Yeah, her attorney.
She had a baby a year ago.
Look up her attorney.
Did he fuck her while she was pregnant? That's my thing, girl.
Yeah, he goes,
remind me of my mom when I was three.
I love to double down. They go, Usher, don't double down tonight. I go, I want a pregnant woman. Her attorney, Lisa Bloom, says one of her other two clients. Dude, so that lawyer is a scummy motherfucker. She's got two of the clients. She's like, perfect.
The lawyer?
Yeah.
Of course.
The lawyer's representing multiple ones of them.
Absolutely.
It's her firm.
Of course it is. Hi, I'm Lisa Bloom. Have you fucked a pop star and want to embarrass them publicly?
Are you a black that needs a white sitting next to you in front of a podium?
Oh, she is.
Well, look no further.
She's a talk show host?
Find it.
Why? Yep.
Hey. It's me, Lisa. I don't get paid until you get some famous dick.
She does all of her daytime commercials or Usher songs.
And she goes, yeah. Do you feel like suing a guy that had a couple top hits in the early 2000s?
You hear that song? That song paid for my house.
Hi.
I'm Lisa Bloom.
Pick an Usher song. I'll win you $25 million. I really have nothing else to do but to bleed that son of a bitch dry.
Let's take our last break. And
he's been spreading sores all over the Georgia area for over 12 years.
Let's see if we can find her talk show, and we'll come back and wrap this bitch up.
Oh, I want to find this Lisa Bloom because I love scummy lawyers.
I love you.
I love you.
It's the Bonfire.
I should tell you something. As we go our separate ways.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
No such thing as too much Lee Majors, buddy.
I Jacob agrees with you. It's the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. We're doing Duster Rock all day.
Well, I've never seen Lee Majors wear a duster, but if I ever had to describe a song that was Duster Rock...
It's the Fall Guy?
Come on, man. Stuntman? I'm the unknown stuntman. If anybody needs it. Is that Quantasia?
Yeah, she is good with makeup.
What do you mean good?
Like she can make her face look thinner than it is with makeup.
Yeah, but it looks like her face is coming out of a couch. Photoshopped. looks like she's crawling out of a couch or something.
Did she, so she was big when she fucked Usher.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think she gained 200 pounds in a year.
Did we find anything on her lawyer, Lisa Bloom? Because I read another article where they said that Usher hired Lisa Bloom to defend him.
Do you know what I would have respected from her?
What?
When she goes...
And I was backstage, and then Usher was like, I want you. And I know. I was thinner.
she immediately interrupts the press conference.
Yes, I was in much better shape. I was coming off a good summer. And I know, before you laugh, I get it. It was a couple of years back.
All right, so that is the woman that's representing.
Yeah, she's like a lawyer. She's a celebrity lawyer.
And she holds a book and a picture. That's what I'm talking about, the posing, dude.
Oh.
Maybe open the book to the middle, like we happen to catch you in the middle of reading this giant law
Can
book.
Can you bite your glasses like you just made a great point? Uh-huh, now what do you think about
that? She goes, Usher gives herpes to everybody.
The guy is an epidemic.
Make glasses bite down.
Can you find clips of her show?
I help large black women who can't help themselves.
I enjoy embarrassing sexy men.
Usher. Hold on. Usher should get sentenced to having the fucker again.
He goes, you have to do it again.
With no condom.
Again. Oh, man.
This is her on The Young Turks. I can't find clips of her actual show.
Oh, okay.
Oh, what's she thinking about? Oh, she's probably anti-George Zimmerman, too, right? Is that what you're going to tell me now?
She goes, I'd defend him for the right money.
Yeah, really. She would.
No,
that's the thing.
Fucking 1,000%.
They're all dirt balls, man. Yes, exactly. If Johnny Cochran would have found out that they could have given, if they would give him like $50 million to just work for the state.
She's Gloria Aldridge's daughter. Mike in Wisconsin. Who's Gloria Aldridge's daughter?
Allred.
Allred.
Gloria Allred, the attorney.
Yeah.
Celebrity attorney. That's her daughter.
Is it? I believe that. It looks like her. That's what I thought it was at first.
So this is just a family practice.
Absolutely.
So they just go after
it. I'll get off. I love the show. Thank you.
Thanks, man. Well, that's crazy. Oh, I know her.
Yeah, she stands next to other black people always.
Do you think she's like, that's the Aldridge secret?
They do. Didn't she comes up? She jumps in next to everybody who's accusing somebody of something, right?
What a scummy family business.
What's her famous cases? Gloria Allred famous cases.
I don't know, but
she did the same exact thing as her mom.
That's crazy that they just go to, like, that's their thing, is like to sue a celebrity for the money they made. What pieces of shit. Just honest to God pieces of shit.
Well, I mean, look, they need lawyers. Here they go. High profile.
Not the ones that chase this kind of bullshit. Oh, OJ.
Oh, the face-eating cannibal.
The face-eating cannibal.
Oh, she's like, you might know me from my work with the OJ Simpson trial.
Dodi Al-Fayed.
Oh, she represented Nicole Simpson's family.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. No, she wasn't going to go for OJ. No. She'd be the one right next to Ron.
Yeah.
Mustache waxing Ron, Fred Goldman's mustache.
She goes, how great's his mustache? We're going to make so much money in civil court.
We're going to get so much scratch. Yeah. Scott Peterson trial.
Oh,
fuck. By the way, that's coming back again. They're doing a whole story about
it. Wait, but hold on.
He's finally talking.
Amber Frey was the ex-girlfriend of Scott Peterson, a California man who was convicted of murdering his wife and whose trial became a national sensation. Wait, go back up, Christine. You skipped by. Frey hired Allred to guide her through a wave of media attention. So she is. She's the one that, like, yeah, she's the perfect stand next to me.
She's the ambulance chaser of famous cases.
I got you. Yeah, and she represents like the third tier scary spice.
That's Mel B.
Yeah. When the woman, I love what you do. The woman,
I absolutely loved it.
Loved it.
When she was my lawyer, I absolutely loved it.
I took it out of Norbit's ass, claiming.
He claimed that he fathered Scary Spice's child. Allred was there. A paternity test proved she was right. And
yeah, but Gloria Allred just can't wait to just dig into the ass of like a celebrity.
Yeah, if you're a celebrity in your life and you slip up a little bit, Gloria Allred's gonna just fucking ping you for it.
And now her dumb daughter's doing the same thing.
Oh, Britney Spears' bodyguard, the Tiger Woods scandal.
Mom, you'll never guess. Mom, you'll never guess.
Guess what I landed.
Well, I'll tell you what, 400 pounds of awesome just walked through my door.
Mom, I got my white whale, but it's a black lady. My ship has come in. Well, a woman the size of a ship.
Oh, yeah, Rachel, that was the Tiger Woods thing. They were like,
You know Gary Veeder used to walk her dog?
Rachel, you could tell?
Yeah.
Yeah, isn't that weird? Like, Gloria Allred's the one who stands behind. Exactly. It's
Anthony
like
Wiener.
A guy fucks a girl.
And Anthony Weiner. God, this lady is a piece of shit.
Yeah, but it really is like, she goes to the thing exactly. It's always like, she really seems to represent like the, you're a dumb woman who didn't know any better. Let me stand up for you.
Let me make money for you ruining these people's lives.
But it really, I mean, these people aren't scumbags, the people she's going against. But I mean, like, obviously Scott Peterson's a piece of shit.
Yeah, of course.
But she doesn't
fucking
murder. But she's not even worried about taking care of like Lacey Peterson. It's like, let me navigate this girl because, now they're going to try to get her to do a sex tape, and they're going to try to get like everything like that.
She goes, what do you want? What plan do you want? Do you want the Supreme package? That's where you get butt fucked on tape. I release it 3 weeks later. We split the profit. Can you have a kid with him? If you can have a kid with him, I can probably sell him on the black market.
You know,
make some money.
You know, I saw him the other day. I forgot about it. Oh, I forgot all about
it. I love the night court thing.
The teen mom.
Porn with James Dean?
Yeah. I really like, from still being on TV, that's like so insanely graphic.
What, the Teen Mom sex tape?
It's like over the top even for a sex tape. Like what she does.
With James Dean?
She does everything.
Yeah.
Everything.
It's funny with you saying that with the Night Court theme in the back, and it goes, everything.
Everything. She does it all.
So Gloria Allred.
All the hits.
Gloria Allred and her daughter both are in the same business as shit. I wonder who Gloria Aldred's husband is.
She's like, oh, baby, you don't understand. I got James Brown on the same thing. He also into pork chops.
Yeah.
Just stand next to her. Stand next to her.
Don't try to
spray it down so she doesn't smell like salted meats.
Don't get sucked into her gravitational pull.
Not make house calls. Do not go to her neighborhood.
He was an aerospace entrepreneur.
Oh, so he was rich.
Who, her dad?
No, her ex-husband.
Her ex? Of course she's good in court. You don't want to marry her. Then you go to divorce court with that? She's going to fucking dink. I mean, she'll really get you.
I deserve half because he gave Usher herpes. Who gave herpes to this woman?
It's the
who got OJ in trouble?
It's the old family secret.
Just claim they have herpes. You don't even need to get it. It's what my grandfather brought over on from the old country.
Dude, it's so funny that Usher now his legacy will have to be
fat girl herpes.
They just like he gave people herpes or he has herpes. It's you got to get out of this business at some point.
That's where you think that's
or it's got to be something where this doesn't hurt you at all. This doesn't hurt.
Like, I think this goes back down, and I don't think it affects him basically because like.
Well, he was already sort of like fading out of the mix anyway.
Nah, he'll be fine. He'll do another hit in 2 years and people will forget.
Well, his big thing was producing Bieber. That was like his last
do you think
hurrah,
Bieber
right?
has herpes?
Do you think Bieber's the guy?
Oh, Bieber's patient zero. Oh. It's some rare Canadian strain.
Oh, Justin Bieber's the outbreak monkey?
Oh, yeah.
He spit in Usher's mouth and then it fucking infected him?
Yeah, he has herpes simplex queef.
Oh, that's the beta test version. That's all the way to ground zero.
You remind me of a girl. Well, look, Usher likes him big, so I guess I have a shot.
So Lisa Bloom's the JV.
He likes blowing dudes and big girls. So maybe I just see my heaving back going up and down on his lap.
Yeah.
What do you think? Does that do anything for you? Yeah. Lose?
Lose, you guys into that?
Lose, you guys into seeing my back? There's heat like a Tasmanian devil just heaving up and down.
That would be great if they're like, if I just get a text and say Bonfire's canceled, and I'm all, what does that mean? And then I see a press conference with you and Lisa Bloom, or you get her mom, you get Gloria Allred, and you're all,
he was my band have no sound. I was wearing my birthday crown.
Yeah. Jay was there. He noticed my Eagle jersey.
He was like, you looking to fly? And he said, you're wearing sweatpants shorts. I bet those come off easy. And I was like, I don't know. I guess whatever.
You want to rub against him?
And then he distracted me by he handed me almost a complete full a tube of Pringles. And then I wasn't even looking. Next thing I know, he's doing things to my dookie hole.
Big J. Oakerson's going to be at the Funny Bone in Omaha, Nebraska, Thursday, August 24th through Saturday, August 26th. And then after that, you can catch him at Rick Bronson's House of Comedy in Minneapolis, Thursday, September 7th through Saturday, September 9th. Go get tickets at BigJComedy.com. Also, our friend Ryan Hamilton's special Happy Face is going to be premiering on Netflix August 29th, so make sure you check that out. And I will be a part of Sam Roberts' wrestling podcast.
Yeah.
This Wednesday.
Also, that's it. You really jumped in there and
sorry,
stole your entire
that.
Thing. Dan Soder is going to be on Sam Roberts' wrestling podcast.
Yeah.
For information, it's live at Highline Ballroom in New York City. Wednesday, August 16th at 8 p.m. You can get your tickets at HighlandBallroom.com.
You can.
And I'm going to be in Omaha, Nebraska.
Yeah. There you go.
I took a little away from you now.
Fine. At the Bonfire, SXM, Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat.
Dan Soda insulted my intelligence. He stole my plugs. And I know. Now listen, Jay, hi. This is Lisa Bloom. What if I told you to sue Dan for all of his video games? Probably. I was wearing my birthday sash, and I know that's the reason he talked to me. He watched me take down a cotton candy in one fall swoop. I took it down the way a python takes down its feet. I was eating corn on the cob the way I do, where I put the whole cob in my mouth and then just pull it out. Have you ever seen a cartoon where they eat a fish and just the bones come out? I did that with a dick. Now, I gotta get some food in me or else my lawyer starts turning into giant pieces of meat like I'm lost in the desert.
She goes, oh, she's fun, isn't she? We're gonna make a lot of money.
She's just putting on a napkin and having a fork and knife.
We're going to make a lot of money. Bloom, I'm about to eat your ass. You don't give me so many money.
We'll see you guys tomorrow, 6 p.m. You know, Eastern.
Love you, Dan Soder.
Love you, Big J. Everson.